Hello everyone, this is Amir Yassin from Autodesk, bringing you another tutorial series that we hope you will enjoy. In this 18-part tutorial, you bring together two Autodesk applications that are important for design animation. These are Autodesk Revit and Autodesk 3ds Max Design. If you only have 3ds Max, don't worry. What you learn here can be done using 3ds Max as well. Both Revit and 3ds Max Design are part of many Autodesk suites, but you can also use the standalone version. We hope this series will appeal to both the Revit user who wants to learn more about 3ds Max, and also to the 3ds Max user who wants to experiment with Revit's intuitive approach to architectural modeling. You start the tutorial series in Revit, where you learn about prep work and other cleanup procedures. These are important to minimize time and effort once you export the scene to 3ds Max Design. The scene you will be working on is a museum building designed by Mike Began, an architect from the city of Chicago. You'll learn to remove or add detail where needed, in addition to making material adjustments directly in Revit. You then learn about different ways to transfer information between Revit and 3ds Max. In the process, you learn about filtering the data that passes through and how to adjust the scene accordingly. Special attention is given to cameras and lights. Ultimately, you bring your museum model into an existing city block and position it appropriately. After fine-tuning the building's position, you adjust materials and add trees around the plaza. Finally, you learn to use 3ds Max Design's superior functionality to animate cars by placing them on paths, cameras using simple keyframing methods, and pedestrians using a 3ds Max Design native tool called Populate. When all is done, you will have a finalized project that includes the best of both Revit and 3ds Max Design worlds. So, when you're ready, move to the next movie in the series to take a look at basic setup work.